गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो वी आर बैक विद द न्यू लेक्चर फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इंजीनियरिंग वन। माय सेल्फ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर नितीश मोहिते, वर्किंग इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग इन भारती विद्यापीठ कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग कोल्हापुर, एंड आई कंप्लीटेड मास्टर्स इन इंजीनियरिंग इन सिविल स्ट्रक्चर्स। ओके, so in the we'll have a brief revision what we have seen in the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture we have seen the correspondingly points like road development plan, how it was been developed, what were the road plan. So first one was Nagpur road plan, then it was Bombay road plan, then it was Lucknow road plan, how the classification was of the road was been done. Okay, then correspondingly what are the what done by NHAI, NHDP, MSRDC, what are the objectives of MSRDC, that also we have seen. Okay, so moving further to the today's lecture. Okay, so in the today's lecture we are going to cover these points, that is highway financing, then classification of roads, then what do you mean by highway alignment, what are the requirements of good highway alignment, then what are the factors that control the alignment. Okay, so these points we are going to cover in the today's session. Okay, so starting with the first, highway financing. So as the name indicates, highway financing, finance means nothing but funds. Okay, so you require money in order to do the construction, in order to do the maintenance. Correspondingly, whatever if any addition is supposed to be done, correspondingly you are supposed to raise the funds. So how we are going to do that, that we are going to see in this point, that is highway financing. Okay, yeah, so highway financing is nothing but an aspect of raising the funds necessary for the construction and maintenance of a new highway project or improvements to an existing road. So that is nothing but highway financing. Okay, so correspondingly, which comprises the analysis of costs, different methods of financing highway projects, sources of revenue, and different organizations involved. So basically what happens, an approximate cost of the construction of the road is being decided. Okay, initially only, as we are knowing that estimate is required, unless and until we are not knowing what is required amount required for the said new construction or for the maintenance or for improvements to an existing roads, we cannot raise according to that funds or make arrangement for the same. Okay, so the thing is that correspondingly funds that are been either taken as a loan or they are been raised from certain government taxes. Okay, that we are going to see here. Okay, so the funds necessary for this are realized from the main beneficiaries, that is nothing but we are knowing that the main beneficiaries are nothing but the road users, so in the form of direct and indirect taxes. Okay, so in the previous lecture also we have seen that one point, that was nothing but golden quadrilateral and north south east west corridor. Okay, so for example in that case it was been decided that approximately 58,000 crores were being required, approximate. Okay, so this much amount of money from where you are supposed to make arranged. Okay, so correspondingly it was a case that from various organizations 20,000 crores from were arranged, then correspondingly then cess was been laid. Okay, on petrol and partially for the diesel, and correspondingly certain loan was been taken from the World Bank and the Asian Development Bank loans. Okay, and so on, and some from market is been taken, and correspondingly from the certain private sectors. So likewise you can do the arrangement. Okay, so basically there are two common methods of raising the finances for highway. Okay, so they are nothing but pay as you go method. Okay, and second one is nothing but credit financing method. Okay, So we'll see one by one. So in the pay as you go method, what has been seen that in this method, funds are been collected by the government in the form of several types of taxes from the beneficiaries. So primarily, the road users are utilized to implement new highway projects or improvements to existing ones, and also for maintaining them. Okay. So in this case, correspondingly, what happens? Whomsoever is going to utilize that project, from them, the correspondingly taxes will be taken, and correspondingly funds will be made available for that. Okay. In the next, credit financing method. So in this method, funds are raised by the government by borrowing money from the general public through credit bonds guaranteed by the RBI on the behalf of the funds. Okay, so you might have heard. So we can take an example of local, that various what you call it as certain authorities are there which make available of the bonds in the market, so which you are supposed to take it, and in correspondingly on behalf of that, correspondingly you will be giving certain percentage that you are the beneficiary of that, and it is been guaranteed by the RBI. Okay, so it is nothing but Reserve Bank of India. So such bonds are been available, and from this only the funds are been raised. Okay, and then the construction of the said work takes place. Okay, so the interest payable along with the principal to the purchasers of these bonds is in a time frame of 10 to 15 years, and such payment is met from the future income. Okay, so as I told you, certain interest has been laid. So that interest is been given after a duration of 10 to 15 years. That is nothing but unless until that project is being completed and we are getting the funds again, or whomsoever is the beneficiary, from that we are going to take the said certain taxes, from that only, that whatever is the extra payment we are going to get, it that will be provided as an interest. So funds may be borrowed from the international lending agencies such as the World Bank and Asian Development Bank, and returned with interest in a mutually agreed time frame of say 10 to 20 years. So as I told you, this Asian Development Bank or the World Bank provides us the loans. Okay, not the local bank which is present there. Okay, so they are not capable of providing such kind of funds. So till now it is been told that we are supposed to take the, or the government takes the loans from the World Bank and the, or the Asian Development Bank, and certain interest has been laid. So the interest is lesser one, but within a time frame that you are supposed to pay in the interest. Okay, so in such case, in order to raise the funds, we either also one can go with the various models of degree enrollment in such a case of private sectors or organizations, that is, we know that build, own and operate and transfer, that is BOT approach, then correspondingly build, transfer and operate, that is BTO approach. Okay, then finance, build and lease approach. Okay, or it may be completely owned, financed and operated by the private body only. So basically, out of this, all these models, build, own and transfer is generally considered, as we are knowing that it is most effective form of private sector. And in that also, there are various variations are there. It might be build, own and operate. It might be build, own, operate and sell. Okay. It might be build, operate, lease and transfer, or build, own, operate and transfer. Okay, so as we are knowing that in such a case of this transportation, we require much amount of investment, and in such a cases, the funding are not possible to raise on an individual. Okay, so in that case, we are supposed to do the proper implementation, okay, for the completion of the said project. So how the sources of revenue are generated for highway financing? So the central government imports duty on motor vehicles and spares, then correspondingly on petroleum products, next excise duty on vehicles and spares. Okay, then excise duty on petroleum products, same, and tolls at selected locations like bridges and special roads like expressways and national highways. So likewise, the central government makes arrangement for the highway financing. Next, the state government, what does they do? sales tax on motor vehicles and spares again they lay, then again on petroleum products in addition to that, then motor vehicles tax, annual or life tax. So right now, whenever you are going to go to purchase a new vehicle or get the transfer of the first owner to the second owner, you are knowing that you are supposed to pay certain tax to the RTO. Okay, so that is nothing but motor vehicles tax. It might be annual or it might be life tax. So initially they are telling that we are supposed to pay at least 3 years or 5 years likewise. So from this, the revenue has been generated. So they can levy the tax on the goods on transport, then route permit fees, correspondingly driving license fees and toll levied by states. Okay, so along with the central government, this state government also lays certain taxes on the person who is going to make use of this, all these sources that are made available. It might be petrol, it might be vehicle, it might be taking the driving license or going through from one state to another through the toll or do the provision or transfer of the goods. Okay, so correspondingly that in that form the sources of revenue are being generated. Okay, so that was regarding the highway financing. Moving to the next part. Classification of roads. So basically we have seen the classification of road as per the Nagpur road plan was nothing but national highways, state highways, major district roads, then village roads, other district roads. Okay, but later on as per the Lucknow road plan, okay, in which correspondingly the expressways were included and the classification of road was been classified as primary, secondary and tertiary. So in the primary, it was been decided that expressways and national highways should be included. In secondary, state highways and major district roads should be included. And in the tertiary classification of roads, other district roads and village roads should be included. So what do you know expressways? We'll see one by one. So the expressways, we are knowing that, so they are nothing but the separate class of highways with superior facilities and design standard and are meant as through routes having very high volume of traffic. Okay, so basically you might have seen that whenever you go through the highways, okay, so separate this expressways are been not provided at each and every corner or correspondingly at each and every place. Okay, so they are being provided in such a case where there are chances of getting traffic congestion. Okay, and correspondingly in such a case only the expressways are being provided. So in such a case the cars or vehicles which are supposed to make use of that expressways can move at higher speeds. Okay, so correspondingly in this case this highway should permit only fast moving vehicles. Okay, so they are owned by central government or state government depending upon whether the route is a national highway or a state highway. So in addition to that, these expressways are being just correspondingly carried out. Okay, so we can take an example that it is nothing but Pune-Mumbai expressway is a example. Okay, so correspondingly, so these are being constructed, as I told you, with respect to very specifications which are being laid down by the IRC that meets the standards of, if you take an example of the geometric design, what should be the pavement width likewise. And one thing on the expressways, no pedestrian is allowed. Okay, next is nothing but national highways. Okay, so the national highways are the main highways which run through the length and breadth of the India and join the main parts, capital of the states and large industrial and tourist centers, which includes various roads required for a strategic movement for the defense of India. Okay, so basically you can call it as NH4 hour is nothing but Mumbai Bangalore. We call it as Pune Bangalore. Okay, so generally it is Mumbai Bangalore and Chennai. So right now it has been revised name. Okay, so other national highway one, okay, it is Delhi Ambala Amritsar and crossing to the Indo-Pak border. Then national highway two is starting from Delhi joining Agra, then Kanpur and Kolkata. Then NH17, you can take an example. It is of Mumbai Panji. So basically, the width of this national highways varies from 7 meter to 15 meter in India. Then they are been assigned with the numbers. Likewise, NH1 Amritsar Ambala Delhi Road, then Agra Mumbai Road, NH3, and so on. Okay, so that was dealing with the national highways. Moving to the next, that is state highways, which is denoted as SH. So these are the arterial roads. Okay, so which joins the adjacent states, district headquarters, and important cities with the states. So that are called as state highways. Okay. So the responsibility of the construction and maintenance of the state highways is taken by the state government. So till now, whatever the national highways and the expressways, that construction and maintenance has been taken, considered by the central government or a private sector which has been appointed for the said construction. So the geometry design specifications and the design speed for the national highways and state highways are the same, as we are knowing that. Then the length of the state highway road varies from 7 meter to 10 meter. Okay. Moving further, that is major district roads. So the major district roads are one of the important roads which are located within the district. Okay. So which connects the areas of production and marketing with each other. Okay. Or with the main highways, we are knowing that. And correspondingly, the responsibility of construction and maintenance of these major district roads are associated with the district authorities. Okay, so local authority, whomsoever is there, so that are supposed to take the responsibility of construction or maintenance of the said major district roads. So the state government gives grants for the development of major district roads. So alone, the said local authority cannot raise the fund. So for that purpose, they are supposed to make a provision that they are supposed to ask for the funds, and correspondingly, after availability of the fund, they go for the construction or maintenance of the said major district roads. Okay, next is the other district roads, that is ODR. So these are the roads which are ruling the areas from production, providing them with the market centers, headquarters, and block development headquarters, railway station, etc. Okay, so this they play an important role. Okay, so where there is nothing but industrial area, okay, so where the production takes place, so which connects the market centers, headquarters, and block development headquarters. So correspondingly, directly they can join to the railway station. So these are nothing but the other district roads, ODR. And last one is nothing but the village roads, classification of roads. So the roads which connect the villages or groups of villages with each other, with the nearest road of the higher category. So higher category, it might be national highway also directly, or it might be correspondingly major district road or other district road. Okay, so that is nothing but the classification of the roads. Okay, so they play an important role in the development of the rural areas. Okay, moving further to the next point. Okay, that is nothing but highway alignment. Okay, so this highway alignment is not a new word, because we have conducted one project, road project. Okay, so road is nothing but correspondingly a part of highway only. So alignment, so it is nothing but the center alignment. So on left and right hand side, correspondingly the staff readings are being taken, where the cutting is there, where filling is there, how the gradient should be given. Okay, corresponding volume of cutting and filling we are finding out. So in order to decide that or define that or do the estimate of that, we require the proper alignment of the road, or it might be highway. So that we are going to see here. So the position or layout of center line of the highway on the ground is nothing but an alignment. Okay, that we are knowing it. So here you can see, okay, here you can see that this is an example which is nothing but which is highway alignment. Okay, so this is also second part, but this is the good one because it joins it straightly. Okay, so this is an example of highway alignment. So there should not be any more amount of turns, or it should not be a steep one. Okay, so such cases we are supposed to take into consideration, and according to that only we are supposed to make the provision of the highway alignment. So that we are going to see here, that is the requirements of an ideal alignment. So whenever you are going to work as an highway engineer, okay, so you should take into consideration this, the basic requirements for provision of the ideal alignment. So what it is? Short. So what do you mean by short? So correspondingly, the alignment between the two stations, so between which we are going to connect the two points or two locations, so it should be short and it should be provided with a straight alignment. Okay, but practical consideration may cause deviations from the shortest path. Okay, so we are knowing that if we are going to provide a shortest path, okay, so certain deviations are required in such a case. That is nothing but the short. Then next one is the easy. So the alignment should be such that it is easy to construct and maintain the road. Okay, the alignment should be easy for the operation of the vehicles with easy gradient and curve. Suppose if you are providing a steep gradient, correspondingly a steep curve is provided, or directly there are certain amount of curves, so that are been, they are supposed to be correspondingly, you are supposed to take a direct curve. Okay, so it should not be a such a case. So proper maintenance or correspondingly, it should be easy for the driver to drive the car on that. Next one is the safe. So the alignment should be safe in such a manner that it is easy for the construction and maintenance with respect to the stability of natural slopes, embankments, etc. Because we are knowing that it's the greatest task or responsibility of the highway engineer to construct the highways in case of hilly areas. Okay, so correspondingly, whenever you are going to do the construction, you should take into consideration if it is supposed to be do the expansion of the existing road. So in such a case, the whatever the traffic congestion is going to happen, you are supposed to control it. So it should be safer. Okay. And traffic operations with safe geometric features, you are supposed to take into consideration. Next one is the economic. So the alignment should be such an economical that whatever is the construction cost, it should be lesser one. Maintenance cost and vehicle operation cost should be minimum. Next one is the utility and natural aspects. So utility and natural aspects means what? So you should make the make use of the natural phenomena, that is flora and fauna, without disturbing the flora and fauna. You are supposed to construct or provide the alignment. So you can take an example that right now a new highway construction is been going on in the Mumbai. Okay, so or correspondingly green corridor, you can take an example. So without disturbing the flora and fauna, they are providing the piers and correspondingly the structure is going on. So these are the certain requirements of an ideal alignment of the highway. Moving to the next point, factors controlling alignment. Okay, so now we are knowing what are the requirements of the good highway alignment. Okay, then what are the factors? So we have seen that it should be safe, it should be easy, the proper geometric designs should be provided. So what are that? So we'll see one by one. First one is the obligatory, or which are also called as mandatory points. So these are the control points which govern the highway alignment. Okay, correspondingly, it has been told that you are supposed to pass through that point only, or it should not pass through that point. So what is that basic point? So this is nothing but these obligatory points or mandatory points are being classified as, that is the points through which the alignment should pass and the points through which it should not pass. Okay, so from where it should pass, that is nothing but it should be easiest part, it should not cause any maximum deviation. Okay. And points through which it should not pass is nothing but suppose there is presence of any temple is there, mosque is there, church is there, or any heavy structure is there, or which is costlier. Okay, so in which case it is not able to take or make availability for the funds for taking it. So we'll see that points, how the classification is done. First one is nothing but the points through which the highway alignment should pass. Okay, so you can take an example that, so when you are going to provide a highway, okay, and this was the proposed alignment, okay, but correspondingly you are knowing that there is a presence of the river. Okay, So in such a case, you are supposed to make availability of the bridge, okay, so that you can pass it from there. So nothing but, so some of the examples are bridge site. So the bridge can be located only where the river has straight and permanent path, and also where the abutment and pier can be strongly founded. So in this case, the road approach to the bridge should not be curved, and skew crossing should be avoided as possible. So those to locate a bridge, the highway alignment may be changed. Okay, so that I was saying that correspondingly, if this is the highway alignment, so it is not possible to pass the vehicle through this river. So in such a case, you are supposed to construct the bridge where it becomes exactly perpendicular to the direction of the flow of the water of the river, and correspondingly, in which it is possible to construct the pier and embankment. In that case only you can go for the provision of this alignments. This is the case of bridge site. Next one is the mountain. Okay, so when the alignment passes through the mountain, so various alternatives are there. Okay, so which depends upon the topography. So it might be correspondingly due to the presence of steep slope, you are supposed to change the alignment, or certain excavation is to be done, okay, or depending upon the site conditions and construction and operation costs. Okay, next, correspondingly it should also join the intermediate town. Okay, so here you can see this was the proposed alignment of the road, but intermediate town should also be considered. In due consider that, correspondingly what happens if the said, if you are going to take into consideration such town, okay, so it can also get benefited, okay, and correspondingly the person who is going to come or travel from this point, okay, can get an advantage of traveling through this. Okay, so that is nothing but correspondingly going through the intermediate town. Okay, next one, the points through which the alignment should not pass. So some of the examples are, so religious places, okay, correspondingly buildings which are correspondingly having costlier, okay, so in such a case we are supposed to make the diversion or take the deviation in the alignment. Okay, in such a case you are supposed to provide the deviation. Or in the presence of the pond also, you can see an example here. So due to the presence of the pond, it is not possible to make the provision. So in that case, you are going to make the deviation. So in such a case, it should not pass like this. Okay. Next points are nothing but geometric design features. So geometric design feature means what? What is the curve of the road, the radius of the curve? What is the gradient of the road? Okay, then what is the site distance? Then what is the super elevation? Okay, so that points we are going to cover in this geometric design features, so which are required. Okay, then next, so in this, as I told you, the geometric design factors such as gradient, radius of curve, site distance, etc., governs the alignment of the highway. Next is the traffic requirements. So the alignment of the highway or the road should be such that it should meet the traffic requirement, both present right now and coming future. So according to that, you are supposed to do the construction of the provision of the highway alignment. Next one is the economy. So correspondingly, the economy or the finance which is required, or the initial cost of the construction of the alignment, should be such that it should be meet the said, whatever is the estimated cost is required, that it should meet, and correspondingly it should not be a case that when the work is been taken and the cost of the said project goes on increasing, it should not be a case, and maximum provision of deep cuttings should be avoided. So it should be done in such a manner that the amount of cutting and filling should be matched. Okay. And other considerations like strategic factors, political considerations, environmental aspects, hydrological factors, drainage considerations, okay, and monotony. Okay, so correspondingly, it should not be a case that it is a very long stretch of absolutely straight road. Okay, so correspondingly these are the other considerations that are supposed to be taken into considered, that from where the alignment of the road should pass, okay, and when you are going to pass or make the provision of the alignment of the highway, in such a case all these points should be taken into consideration, and then only you can move further for the said construction of the highway. Okay, got it. So in the today's lecture we have gone through the points like correspondingly what do you mean by highway financing, then what is the classification of roads, then what do you mean by highway alignment, then what are the factors or the requirements of an ideal alignment, then correspondingly what are the factors which govern the correspondingly highway alignment. Okay, in the next lecture we will see correspondingly that what are the geometric designs actual, okay, and based upon that we are going to solve the various numericals, because in such a case that we have seen one term or heard one term that is nothing but the side distance. Okay, so you are going to calculate the side distance at which the vehicle is going to stop, or you can take the overtaking of the said our vehicle. Okay, thank you.